Let's welcome Vivica von Rosen. Look at that. Look at that strut. All this aggravation is satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less smart. A little less fight, a little more smart. Close your mouth and open up your heart. And baby, satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby.
All right. Baby, close your eyes. Little Elvis. Bet Elvis never thought he'd be in Lima. And purple shoes. I think it's very important when you speak at events to match the background. So thank you, eating lunch, and we're talking about LinkedIn, the most exciting social media platform there is. All right, show of hands, you can be completely honest, I don't mind. How many of you love LinkedIn? Kate, you can put your arms down. Awesome. How many people, again, be honest, I totally get it. How many people think LinkedIn is a complete waste of time and a spammy, spammy, spam bot land? Really? Only one? You be that person. Thank you, Jordash. So here's the thing. And actually, Kate said this the other day, who you will be hearing from in just a little while. She made a really good point. She said, you know what? When you get all that spam in your inbox, it's because you're showing up. You know what? She's absolutely right. And I never, the LinkedIn expert, never really thought about that before. So thank you, Kate, and I hope you weren't going to use that in your presentation. Okay, so today we're going to talk about three steps to a successful LinkedIn pivot. And you know, and then I remembered that the name of this conference was Emerge. So we're going to talk about three steps for a successful LinkedIn Emerge, because not everybody here is pivoting. Is there anyone pivoting, looking for a new job, pivoting what their business is? Do we have anyone? A few of you. Okay, so that's good, because now I'm going to talk to you about how to make your businesses emerge on LinkedIn. Now, I'm talking about personal profiles today, because Kate's going to talk about company pages. And we're going to do a table talk, so you can come to our table and ask us any questions you have. When it comes to your brand on LinkedIn, there are three things that you must do, right? You need to build credibility. How often have you heard this already in the past 36 hours? Your online relationship is built on trust. It's that KLT, that know, love, and trust. So that's important. The other thing, you need to show how you solve problems. How many of you, again, just a show of hands, be honest, how many of you have a resume on LinkedIn? Yeah. Because a lot of people think LinkedIn is just for finding jobs. And it used to be, 20 years ago, people, but still, it used to be. And so a lot of people still think that LinkedIn is about a resume. But of course, we want to focus on our buyers. So the number one thing is you want your LinkedIn profile to be a resource, not a resume. And we're going to talk about that a little bit today. The third thing, you want to create those conversations. Now, Elvis was saying a little less conversation, a little bit more action, baby. I want you to have more conversations, and I want that to create the action of business for you. So those are the three things we're going to talk about. Branding. That banner. How important is that banner? I mean, look at this one that Jessica has, right? Love more, give more, be more. I love that. How many of you are making full use of your banner? Right? Five reasons to have a good banner. It's the first thing your buyer's going to see. I don't know what's going on between Google and LinkedIn, but there's something a little kinky going on, because when you go into Google and type a person's name in, a lot of time it's your LinkedIn profile that shows up. How many people are jumping into your LinkedIn profile and it sucks, right? And it might be costing you business. So you've got to make at least top of the fold, people, at least top of the fold. You got to make use of that banner. It's the first thing the buyer sees, and they probably got driven to your LinkedIn profile from Google. It's at the top of your profile, so it's where eyes go. It's free advertising. It's a visual imprint of your brand. Please, please, no one have that blue basic background. And it's a potential call to action. CTA, we've heard a lot of people talking about CTAs today. So you want to make use of that. Look at how brilliant. All right, I'm giving Chad a compliment. Look at how brilliant this background image is. It's simple, it's clean. Ask me to tell you a story. I love that. Right, here's Kate standing out online, leveraging your personal brand. Boom. Love this. Clean, easy. And then there's mine for my software company, which I'm not talking about today. Flymessage.io, it's a Tauto text expander. It'll help you to type less and do more. So those background images, oops, went the wrong way. Up, can't go the, I've learned now, you can't back up. You can never go back. There you go. So you want to make sure that that visual brand is there for your audience, for your prospects, for your clients, for your next boss. And here's the thing, it's not one and done. Show of hands, how many people have changed their background image in the past 6 months? A few of you, awesome. Why? Why did you change your brand or your background image? Okay, that's one good reason too, it was terrible. How about you, why did you change it? Love it. It's a call to action. You had a new call to action, right? It's not one and done. This is a great advertising opportunity. Please, folks, when you have something new, change that background image. It's the first thing people are going to see on LinkedIn. Okay, finally. Now it's time for Chad. I'm slightly obsessed. Don't tell Lainey. Compelling headlines. How many people have title at company? Because 13, 17, 22 years ago, that's what LinkedIn told you you had to have, title at company. Oh, thank God, none of you. Okay, good. So you have 220 characters here. But now is I want you to think about your buyer. And Jordash was talking about this. Julia was talking about this. Brian was talking, both Brians were talking about this, right? Know who your buyer is. If you don't know who your buyer is, you're not going to be effective on any socials, clearly, because we're all talking about it. But how many of you are writing your LinkedIn profile specifically for your buyers, their point of pain, and how you can help them? So again, we've got Chad, right? I make you, that's very specific, you and you and you and you, more memorable, right, by teaching speakers, trainers, and brands. That's really who he's working with, teachers, trainers, and or speakers, trainers, and brands to disrupt. How? With joy, disarming with story, delighting with humor, and dazzling with your delivery. Who do you help? How do you help them? He doesn't need to say, you know, this is Chad at Story, nope, Story Brand, nope. Chad, what is it? Story Catcher, thank you, I should have known that. Story Catcher, right? He doesn't need to say that because that headline is grabbing you right away. Mine, I help entrepreneurs, salespeople, and 1 billion knowledge workers to be more productive. Click on the link below. Did you all know in creator mode you can add a hyperlink to your intro section? Did you all know that? So if you get creator mode, make sure to go back into that intro section at the very, very bottom. You can put a link in it because a hyperlink on your intro section. Here's the ninja trick. Then you have to go back in and customize it. The field's not going to show up the first time. So it's nice to have that because you can put that call to action right in your headline and start driving traffic from LinkedIn to wherever you want to send them. And of course, it's not one and done. You've got a new product. You've got a free giveaway. If there's something you want to drive traffic to, get that link in there. And then make sure to put that call to action. Who do you help? How do you help them? What business problem do you solve? I'm not going to go into the About section, but you can, of course, apply that formula to your About section, too. Now, the nice thing about your headline section, it's more than just a title. You focus on who you help. You focus on how you help. You answer the problems you solve. You have up to 220 characters. And it becomes a script for your name recognition. Did you all know you can have a little 10-second audio on your LinkedIn profile telling people who you are and how you help them, and then that way they don't massacre your name if you've got a weird name like me? Does anyone have that activated? I know Kate does. Who's got that little voice? Yeah, voice recognition. And what I love about that is it brings your voice onto your LinkedIn profile, which was kind of static. I was going to talk about the video you can do, but LinkedIn's getting rid of that at the end of the month, which is really too bad. But at least they can hear your voice, and that's going to humanize that sometimes boring LinkedIn profile that you have. So make sure that you use that audio section. We've got Jordash here empowering CEOs and experts to scale via power partners, emerging tech, business growth strategist, tech futurist, keynote speaker, relationship marketing, strategic partnerships, AI and business. It's not, I'm the president of such and such company, because that doesn't matter. It's how can you help me? What can you do for me? And that's what matters on a LinkedIn profile. So that name pronunciation I was just talking about, you can only access it on your phone. You can listen to it anywhere, but you can only access it on your phone, and it's in the intro section, and it's right underneath your headline, almost like they wanted you to use your headline as a script. I would definitely recommend taking a few minutes and letting people know in 10 seconds or less who you are, who you help, and why they should hire you. And of course, because this was originally about a pivot, if you are pivoting your business, you absolutely want to make sure that you're changing all of this to let people know who you are, why they should hire you, and how you can help them. Audience is audience, whether they're buyers, whether they're contractors, whether they're candidates, whether they're potential employers. Your audience is your audience, and as long as you're super clear on who your audience is, you can create a LinkedIn profile that speaks directly to them. It doesn't matter if you're talking to 920 million folks on LinkedIn. It matters that you're talking to the 15, the 20, the 600 who can hire you and make that difference in your life and your business. All right, so how can you influence on LinkedIn? That was all about branding. Now let's talk about influence. And of course, it's content. And here's a lot of facts and figures. Feel free to screenshot it. What it's basically saying is content makes a difference. You've got to be sharing content on LinkedIn. And don't just be sharing some link, because is there enough noise on the internet already? No? Yes, thank you. The answer was, yes, there's too much noise already. You have to let people know in your posts, who are you speaking to, what problem might they be having, and how is this link, this video, this whatever it is, going to make a difference, right? You need, and you've already seen a lot of this on previous slides of previous speakers, your goal is to engage, to educate, to help, to drive conversations and action, to increase referrals, to build your brand. You need to do it as many places as possible, multi-threading. And the reason for that is, as with all socials, although I think LinkedIn's a little bit more honest about it, when you post and someone else shares it, or someone else likes it, or someone else comments on the post, of course, there's a chance of it getting out to a different audience that could potentially use you. So that's why we want to make sure that we are speaking to our relevant audiences so people don't just brush by our content as being irrelevant. Because if we're speaking directly to them, they're going to recognize themselves. All right, so what are some things you can do? Share those recommended articles, personal insights and passions, insights into your corporate culture if you have that, relevant industry news, sharing your blog posts, blah, 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 blah. There's a lot of things that you can do. There's a lot of content that you can share. Do you want to repost a TikTok video? Sure, if it's relevant. our friend Michaela Alexis. Do you guys know Michaela? Yeah, she's amazing. Another LinkedIn expert. She does great TikToks. They're relevant to her audience. She brings them on to LinkedIn. They tend to get more visibility and comments on LinkedIn than they do on TikTok sometimes. I mean, that's the other thing, right? That's why I'm talking about the kind of the honesty of LinkedIn, especially over a Facebook where you almost have to pay to play. Bring your podcast in. Tell people why they want to be listening to your podcast. I mean, there's a lot that you can do there. And for those of you who have small businesses and you're thinking, I can't handle all of this, there's just too much out there, you can use ChatGPT. Yes! I love what Jordash was talking about yesterday. By the way, I did download, I haven't gone and seen the tips, but yes, absolutely, I did that. And I love what he was talking about. You have to season the pan, right, with chat. But once you do that, you can start asking ChatGPT to create content for you that you can get up there in no time. And actually, let me back up a little bit to the beginning of this talk. How many of you have a LinkedIn bio, a LinkedIn about section, a LinkedIn summary section that's okay, it's all right, yeah. How many of you have a rock star stellar one that is awesome? Yeah, of course Kate does. Okay, first tip, if you want a rock star awesome profile, go see Kate. If you need something a little bit quicker, because now you're realizing there's more people going onto LinkedIn and checking out your content, get onto ChatGPT. Hey, ChatGPT, here's my buyer persona, here are my offers, here's the things I do, season that pan. Can you make me an awesome LinkedIn about section? 2,000 characters or less. You actually get 2,600 characters, but ChatGPT is super verbose. And she's kind of like me. She doesn't really listen to time limitations or character count limitations. So you have to tell her or him, it just depends, how do you feel about your chat? 2,000 character limitation, that should give you something around 2,600 characters. But yeah, have chat rewrite it. You could do it right now. How many of you have downloaded the ChatGPT app? Do it right now, because I have a little extra time. I'm talking fast. Go ahead. Go into chat right now. Copy and paste your LinkedIn about section. Pop it into chat and say, write me something better. If you don't like it because it's third person instead of first person, chat will rewrite it for you. Make it first person. You want emojis in there? Put emojis in there. You don't want emojis in there? Take the emojis out. If you ask her nicely, she'll do just about anything you ask her to. It's true. I've got proof. So that's your about section. Now let's back up, go forward in time. She'll also write your posts for you. Your posts now are up to 3,000 characters. Here's the thing about LinkedIn algorithm. They don't care about size. Size doesn't matter. They care about intent. They care about people sticking on your posts, reading your posts, staying on there a little bit longer. And so what you want to do is speak to your audience, which now we've seasoned the pan. Chat knows who your audience is. You want to tell chat, take this piece of content, this blog post, this article, you might have to copy and paste some of the text. Write a LinkedIn post. It's actually 3,000 characters, so let's give her 2,000. 2,000 characters, LinkedIn post, talking about this article. When it comes out and it spits it back out to you, tweak it a little bit. It's not going to take 10 seconds to get that article done, but it's not going to take you 10 minutes either. And ChatGPT learns, and it gets better content and better content and better content over time. And so your articles and your posts are going to get better and better and better over time. And that's going to save you an enormous amount of time because, like Katie said, you need to be consistent. And by the way, the tools that Katie shared, and I don't think I got a screenshot in time, they will work on LinkedIn too. And it's going to make a big difference, and it's going to make your LinkedIn profile more credible and more reliable. All right, so now that you look good, you've got a good brand, now that you're sharing the right content, please start connecting with the right people. It used to be bigger was better. That's not true anymore. If you've got people who are not relevant to your network, release them. It's one of my favorite things to do when working with a client who's changing jobs. Release them as long as they're not going to be relevant to your job in the future. Start connecting with the people, right? First level connections are people you've connected to. Second level connections are friends of friends. Third levels of connections, we don't care about them. So you want to get those first and second level people into your network because those are the folks who are going to be interested in your content and they're going to stick on your content and they're going to start engaging with your content. And it is all about starting those conversations. So here's the thing. Oh, yeah, here are the people you should connect with on LinkedIn. Take a screenshot and next. Okay, so here's the thing. You want to make sure that you are working or finding people who you can get introductions to. Oops, wrong one, but that's okay. Here's the other ninja trick. How many of you are connecting on LinkedIn through mobile because here we are with our mobile phones? Are any of you connecting with each other? Oh, come on, folks. That's what I want you to do at the break. I want you to connect with each other. I'm going to show you a really easy way of doing that in just a few minutes. But the problem with connecting on mobile, right, is when you click on the connect button, it just sends an automatic invitation. And then you can't customize it and say, I was at, you know, hashtag SML23. Let's connect. I saw you at Emerge. Let's connect. And then you get all of those introductions and invitations. You're like, I don't know who that person is. So what you want to do is go to the More button or the three dots, either More or three dots. When you're on your mobile device, when you're on your desktop, it doesn't matter. Just click Connect and you're all good to go. But when you click on More, you're going to have an opportunity to personalize that invitation. So I'm going to show you a really easy way of doing that in just a minute. In fact, here it is. So you can hit Connect if you're on your desktop. Otherwise, you definitely want to hit the More, because otherwise, you're going to get that generic message. And like I said, you always want to customize that message to connect. You always want to do that. Otherwise, you're just one more name that people don't know. And I would think that I would remember you from when we met 10 minutes ago, but I'm old, so I might not. So just remind me that you met me here at Emerge. Finally, wrapping up, please put LinkedIn on your calendar. Just like the gym, until you get into the habit of working out, you might not do it unless it's blocked off in your calendar, because there's always more or more exciting things to do. There's always a TikTok to watch. There's always a reel to shoot. If you don't have LinkedIn calendared in, you're probably not going to do it. So go ahead and put it on your calendar. 5 minutes. Oh my God, when Wiley asked me to write my first LinkedIn book for them, they're like, and the title is LinkedIn Marketing, an hour a day. I'm like, oh crap. Who's got an hour a day for LinkedIn? You do when it starts working for you, but at the beginning, oy, 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 5 minutes, right? 5 minutes so you can start engaging with those individuals and starting those conversations. All right, you might have seen this earlier, the good old Ebbinghaus forgetting curve. I don't have to talk about it because Phil already did. I think he looked at my slides. I'm just saying. You forgot. So I want you to put at least one thing into action that I talked about today, whether it's redoing your about section, whether it's reaching out to somebody on LinkedIn and connecting that are more relevant to your network. I want you to promise me to do at least one thing. I'm going to make it super easy for you. QR codes, people, on your mobile device. Go ahead and pull it out right now and open up, like you don't already have it in your hand, right? Go ahead and open up LinkedIn if you haven't yet done so. Now, there's a search bar on the home screen, search bar at the top. There's nothing on the right-hand side until you click into it. So click into it. As soon as you click into it, a little icon's going to pop up on the right. That's actually a QR code. So the next time you're at a conference, or say in two or three, well, after, after Owen, in the break, pull up that QR code. It is the easiest way to connect with each other. And so your one action item, so you're going to remember what you heard today, at least for me, is take a picture of that QR code, invite me to connect. But since you're on your mobile device, don't forget to hit those three dots and personalize that invite. And just say, you were so awesome. Or you sucked, but you told me to do this and I follow rules. Whatever, I don't care what you say in that invitation to connect. Just do it so that way you'll have the experience of it and you'll be able to connect with other people who truly can help you build your business during our next break. That's all I have for you today. Thank you very much, everybody. Stay tuned for the great Owen video.
Outstanding. This is for you.
Thank you.